Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. It's Charlie Fibrosis, and we are here at North Carolina. Let's get our stuff ready and see what we can do. So Matt 17 has got a car rating of 57. I guess we'll just run this. We'll see how we do. So let's go on to Rockingham and see what we can make with this. Alright, here we go. Qualifying time for the Rock. Okay.
We're in Rockingham, North Carolina, home of the North Carolina Speedway for today's race, the Subway 400. What makes the Rock so tough, Barney?
North Carolina is a fast track, considering it's only a mile long. The corners are tricky, though, and getting off them fast is the key to getting speed down the straightaways.
Ward Burton got himself and car owner Bill Davis their first career victories here at the Rock in the fall of 95.
You know, Ward didn't start out with Bill Davis Racing in 1995. He switched teams with 9 races left in the season, had one heck of a finish with that win and 2 other top 5 finishes.
Behind the lead. more tires, Doc.
Green, green, green. Okay.
Nani?
Okay. So that was a way to win a race. Okay.
What an exciting finish.
Wow, you know, you're right. That was an incredible finish to an even more incredible race. This NASCAR Winston Cup Series is so exciting to watch.
The Aaron's car gets the win.
And rightfully so. He was fast all race long. That whole team deserves a lot of credit for a great win.
We hope you enjoyed today's race as much as we enjoyed bringing it to you. We'll see you next week at Las Vegas.
Well, with that climactic of a finish, well, we finally won Rockingham. That's not even close how I wanted to win it. I just wanted to bring out a yellow so I could at least try and dive it into the pits and then maybe, I don't know, drive my way back up. But, okay. This is about as weird as that Atlanta win from the original attempt at doing career mode. We won! We won! We cheated the system and we won! We won! We won! We won! Yeah! But okay, that was something. So, car's torn up, but almost $1 million right there in the bank. So, I'll take that. Okay. So, yeah. All right. Yeah. Let's go ahead and just save things. And let's get ready for Las Vegas, so. So, I think we're gonna go ahead and use Mat 17 for Las Vegas because WoW, I really just don't have anything available to me to really run. And I know that the Vegas car, I know that the Vegas race is going to be rough on me anyway. So, I think that's what we'll do. We got two races left on the build, one race left on the overhaul. Okay, I think that's just what we'll do. So yeah, let me go add the winner sticker on that and then go from there. Alright, so we got a new paint scheme for Vegas, and this is probably what we're going to be running for at least the next little while. The way that I see it is all of the success, some of that money goes right back into DEI, so why wouldn't they want to bring me on? Except for the fact that, well, some of their equipment has been torn up a little bit, so. So, yeah. We're gonna run the solid white for the most part. Napa Autoplant's Aaron's machine and see what we can do. So yeah. And we got our new decal for our win at the mark. So all right. So now we gotta get some other stuff fixed up. So. I did say that I was going to use Matt 17 for Vegas because I don't really have much of a hope there. So let's do it. Setup time. Qualifying time. Here we go.
Mark the start of the line, buddy. Good luck. Take care of those Goodyear
first.
NASCAR Winston Cup Racing has hit the jackpot this week as we come to Las Vegas Motor Speedway for today's UAW Daimler Chrysler 400. I'm Joe Moore along with Barney Hall. We'll be bringing you all the action right here on MRN. What kind of thing should we look for in this one, Barney?
Well, I think we'll see lots of green flag racing in this one. The track is wide and smooth and there are multiple grooves to work with here. Sometimes the cars can get very spread out in this one.
In 1989, Bobby Hamilton got his first start in NASCAR as part of a production for a stock car racing movie.
Well, that's one heck of a way to break onto the circuit. Wasn't too long before he was racing full-time. He won Rookie of the Year honors in 1991.
Jimmy Spencer has earned the name Mr. Excitement with his all-out aggressive driving style.
Well, every time Jimmy Spencer gets in a race car, you know he's going to drive the wheels off that thing. Sometimes it gets him into trouble, but it makes for some great racing action.
Start your engines.
Well, I'll say this much. If we're going to have a bad race, might as well be at Vegas. And Jimmy Spencer wins.
This was an exciting last lap, wasn't it?
Yeah, these NASCAR Winston Cup races can be hundreds of laps, yet when all is said and done, sometimes there are just a few tenths or even less separating the leaders. That was incredible.
The Aaron's car would like to have finished a lot better, I'm sure.
I hate it for those guys, too. They were so positive about their chances to win this morning, but then they just had a bad race. It happens.
From all of us here at EA Sports and MRN, thanks for joining us today, and we'll see you next time.
Alright, so that's going to wrap it up for this episode. We'll go on to Atlanta and Darlington afterwards, and we'll see how we do. We're still sitting 7th in points, and we could be doing better, but that is okay. Webbo Dine is the points leader. Dale Earnhardt Jr. is only 22 points out of the lead, so it's going to be an interesting season. And anyway, I'll be back next time. Hope you guys take care. See you soon.